Bass Music Movement here with Shadow Child. So I basically wanted to speak to you. You used to go under the name of Dave Spoon, and I've noticed that you've got like a change of style, change of branding and stuff like that. Do you want to tell us a little bit more why you decided to do that?
Well, the Taxman was after me and I had to do something pretty drastic about it. So the only way to do it was to start again. And now as I'm doing interviews, obviously he's knowing. No. I felt like a bit, I was a bit bored with the music, to be honest with you. The electro house thing sort of ran its course for me personally. And I wanted to do something that was kind of a bit more fun again, personally, and remove some musical boundaries that I felt I had.
Yeah.
And luckily it's worked, you know. I've been really fortunate that people have been really supportive and into it, so yeah.
Yeah, cool. Yeah, yeah. So, my favourite track was the Flex remix for Dizzy Rascal that you did.
Yeah.
So how did that come about?
I already had the original. It was actually going to be an original, like the whole backing track was sort of half done, like it was going to be an original Spoon record. Then Dizzy came and asked for a remix, which was amazing, and I knew the vocal would just work over that beat, and it did. So that was it. It was done pretty quickly, and it almost was going to be like the lead mix, whatever,
yeah,
which would have been amazing, but it didn't end up that way in the end.
It was a bit of a breakbeat flavour as well, wasn't it? That's what I loved about it.
Yeah, my roots are sort of in jungle and like early 90s, you know, sort of thing. So yeah. Anything with drum breaks and stuff, I'm always into it.
Yeah, so I've heard in interviews and I've heard you play it as well, like the House Crew stuff. Production house
I
records,
played
the old
it
90s.
Tonight.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, I played that House Crew tonight, see. Festivals like this, that's what that one's for, you know what I mean? People get it and people are looking for something a bit different than they might hear in just a normal club set. So
to break it up
so,
a little
yeah,
bit.
Yeah, yeah. So it went down really, I think it's probably the best it went down.
Yeah?
Like since I did it, yeah.
So you enjoyed your set, everything went well?
Everything was great. Couple of technical things to start with the last DJ getting his sort of kit out of the way, but not a problem, you know, it was fine.
No virtual DJ.
You wouldn't have like, well no, it's cool, that's how it is now.
It's got to be
done,
isn't it?
But you know, there was a lot of things plugging in going on around me and things like that, but I don't think anyone realised out there.
Yeah.
So I just needn't have said anything really.
And you're originally from Portsmouth, is that correct?
I still live there, I live in Southend. Yeah.
I was going to ask where you're based now and stuff.
Yeah, I think, you know, a few years ago I kind of played with the idea of moving it into London, but you know, I'm an hour and a half from London and I live right by the sea, like two roads on the sea, and you know, Portsmouth isn't like, the city isn't on the sea, so the seafront's actually really nice. It's like
a little
village, you know, it's really good.
Yeah.
Nice.
So you're flying out and about, you're very, very busy at the moment. So what's been your highlight so far this summer?
The Dirty Bird party at Sankey's the other week, which was my first one. I've got another one I'm doing with them in a couple of weeks. That was really, really good actually. I guess aside from that, Found Festival, which was in East London. Really surprising, like to play. I don't know what time I played, it was quite early, you know, in the day, and it was tipping down with rain. Got there and there was like 10 people dotted about, but like after two records it was packed.
Everyone
and the sun was
in.
Coming out, you know, and it was a
so
great
it's a highlight for you.
Yeah absolutely, yeah. I love Found Festival, is wicked. I think because it's a new thing, you know, and people had a lot of question marks on what it would be like, do you know what I mean? But it was brilliant.
Yeah. Cool. So if you was to give any advice to anybody trying to break through DJ wise or production, what would you kind of tell them, or would you say to our viewers, because there's a lot of people out there doing, you know, music production and things?
I guess the cliche things is just to find your own thing and just run with it, because that's how you'll stand out, you know, just following whatever's hot at one particular time. It might get you somewhere with a couple of releases, but really finding your own sound and pushing that and just keep going with your own sound will get you somewhere. And also, you know, it's easy now to get your hands on software, whether that's legally or illegally. People load their machines up with all these plugins, all these bits of software, like get to know like two or three things really, really well.
Yeah.
And like learn how to use it inside out. You know, that's what I've done with, I use Reason, you know.
Yeah.
And I use Logic as well, but you know, Reason I know inside out. And you know, that's a real key part of my sound. So
yeah,
that's my advice. Don't give yourself too many things to play with.
Absolutely, cool.
And take breaks, go and have a walk. Don't sit there all day.
Yeah. That's true. And then like what's on your rider? when you kind of play at these things? That's water. What I want to know.
I'm not a big drinker, to be really honest with you. I drink a few times a year. The missus has a gin. Sometimes I have a couple of beers. So it depends what's going on. But I'm just not a big drinker anymore. I used to drink quite a lot when I was DJing. I'd find myself in a bit of a pickle. Which might have been funny for some people.
But swaying left and right, trying to focus on the faders.
The next morning when you got to get up for a flight, it's not so funny anymore, you know.
So are you scared of flying? Are you all right with flying? Does it worry you? It's not really natural, is it, being up there?
That's deep. This is a deep one.
Oh, no.
Yeah. I don't mind flying. Sometimes I'm all right with it. Other times I'm just like the next person, really.
It's
Just get on with it. When you get so busy, it's kind of like just getting on a bus. Do you know what I mean? You don't really think about it.
Definitely. Hope for the best and stuff. You're going to have a thing about it now, aren't you, after you've met me? Okay. What else was I going to ask you? Let me just look at my card here. So what's your plans for the rest of the year? What's Shadow Child? What are you going to bring us?
I've got a big project coming. Can't say any more than that.
Yeah? A really big project?
No, not huge, but... I'm putting together an album.
Oh, brilliant.
And the exact details of that will be sort of coming around the next few weeks.
Yeah.
But there's an album coming that I'll be doing on my own label. And I'll also be releasing some other bits and bobs, some EPs and stuff, and hopefully hooking up something else with Dirty Bird, which is good. That's it, really. Off to Australia for New Year and January. I think I'm going to America before that as well. But it's just like getting out and playing, you know. I'm loving it at the moment because all the music's so fresh. It's not, you know, like what I was doing before. It was kind of getting a bit stale for me personally. And, you know, you just got to go and have a word with yourself and reinvent.
Absolutely.
So
cool.
That's what it's all about. Just keeping the momentum going.
Definitely. Words of wisdom from Shadow Child.
I like to try.
Yeah, and good luck, best of luck with everything that you're doing and your new project. And Bass Music Movement, Shadow Child, signing out.